Christian Chinnock here in the Ateme booth. I've talked with their CTO. I'm going to look what you're looking at here is an LG display, a 4K display, which is just showing a number of different encoding applications here. In particular, they're showing a lot of VVC encoded content, much of it HLG based, much of it running at around 16 megabits per second. There's some concert footage here, there's some Disney footage here. There's actually some Tour de France HLG content that was captured and encoded at 100 frames per second at around 16 megabits per second as well. You're actually now looking at some Explorers content, which is HEVC encoded, running at around 12 megabits per second. All of this stuff is looking very good. They chose this content because it has a lot of difficult encoding aspects to it. Water, there's some lots of glitter and some Carnival content, flashing lights. All looks quite clean. So clearly this is 4K content. So we asked them more about what the story is going to be with 8K VVC encoding. And you can do it offline today. 8K 60 VVC can be encoded offline, but not live yet. They're working on that and hope to be able to show that demo at NAB next year. So that's good news for that codec. They are also showing AV1 as part of this as well. And speaking of AV1, part of that codec, one of the things that they're emphasizing in that is the use of film grain synthesis to reduce the data rate. So when you have film grain in content, which is a lot of creatives want that in their content, it's really hard on the encoder. It's essentially noise. And it's really hard to enclose noise, and when it's decoded, it creates all kinds of artifacts. So you either have to throw a lot of horsepower at it, and you still get artifacts. So the solution that many people are talking about, and Ateme solution in particular, is that they first remove the film grain from the original content using a low-pass filter with some additional temporal filtering. On a frame-by-frame basis, they encode those parameters in the stream in SEI messaging. And then the decoder in the TV will decode the video as normal. And then it goes to a secondary step, which is the film grain synthesis recreation. So it's kind of the inverse of what they learned in the film grain removal process. And so that gets added back in. But the data rate savings are significant when you do this. According to Ateme, you can save typically 50% of the data rate and even up to 90% of the bit rate by doing this removal and reinsertion process. I also learned that they did a VVC kind of internal demo at Roland Garros tennis match here in France this year. It was a 4K VVC live encoding, which went to a TV over an OTT stream, which was successfully done. So VVC is clearly maturing, and I believe that also included MPEG-H audio. But they're working with both immersive technology audios, Dolby Atmos and the MPEG-H. So that's pretty much the story here. Chris Chinnock, AK Monitor.